In the 19th century, more or less since about 1750, we have lived in a world of two cultures, in which we have argued that there are two epistemologies. There's the epistemology of science, and there's the epistemology of the humanities or philosophy. On the one hand, it's an epistemology which insists that the only road to truth is via experiment, via disprovable hypotheses, etc., which is the so-called scientific method, and another sphere which insists, no, the road to truth is through insight, hermeneutic insight, through understanding of particularistic developments as opposed to universalistic generalizations, etc. So we have had this war that has gone on for a good 200 years, but not before. Historically, before it was unified, but it went on. It's been going on for these past 200 years, and the social sciences have been pulled apart in this what came to be called in the late 19th century this Methodenstreit, the division between the nomothetic and the ideographic epistemologies. Now, I don't think this makes any sense. I think we have to understand how the so-called divorce between science and philosophy came into existence, why it's being challenged today, why it will probably go out of existence in the 21st century.